Good evening, folks. It's Diamond from the Oppenheimer Ranch Project and Magnetic Reversal News. Bringing you an update in cosmology. What you're looking at is the polar configuration, the Saturn myth, the idea that our current configuration in our solar system is in fact new. It has not been around for millions of years, unchanged, as is purported by the mainstream. And that recently, Saturn was our sun. And that the current sun that we live under is not one that is at all has been around for a long period of time. In fact, based on conversations I had today, the sun we see today may only be around for the last 40,000 years. And we'll see why in this discussion. A paper coming out May 29th of this year in Reviews of Geophysics, the role of geomagnetic field intensity in late quaternary evolution of humans and large mammals, is shedding light onto theories that we've been delving into for decades. And this includes Electric Universe, Thunderbolts Project, and the Saturn myth, and we're going to be getting to that. But this paper coming out shows that it has long been speculated that biological evolution is influenced by ultraviolet radiation. And this paper concludes that magnetic reversals and the inundation of ultraviolet radiation caused the extinction of Neanderthal, probably, and many other things. We're going to retouch on this paper, but first let us come over to the Saturn myth. Now, according to Dave Talbot and others, major cataclysms, including Velikovsky, major cataclysms disfigured the previous planetary configuration and unleashed major chaos in a formerly advanced human civilization, potentially causing the chaos of the Diluvian, Antediluvian mythology. But what it's looking like is the geomagnetic excursion back 40,000 years ago was the end of the polar configuration and the beginning of the new sun. Now, the polar configuration was when we were riding along smoothly here with Saturn. So here are the gas giants. Here's our proto-brown dwarf Saturn. And then we have the proto-planets. Here's Earth, Venus, and Mars, the anode glow, and probably behind Saturn is Neptune and Jupiter, potentially. And these would have all been connected through a Birkeland current and traveling through space as the way most brown dwarfs travel alone. We would just be floating around until we were captured by the current solar system we live in. Now, that capture could have happened as early as 50,000 years ago. But it is my suggestion that it was probably the Eocene extinction somewhere around 5 million years ago. Our brown dwarf system that we lived in came into the solar system we currently live in. And we sat there for almost 5 million years in a plasma sheath, unaware of the sun and the other planets around us, and unaware of where we were. Until 40,000 years ago, when the polar configuration began to move, the plasma sheath was ripped off and creation began. And all the mythology that you've ever learned about in your life was expounded. Now, the Saturn myth by Dave Talbot, my hero, he interviewed me about 5 years ago when I got my download in 2012. I started posting on the net and Dave Talbot wanted to know why. He contacted me through Susan Schroit, who is the head of the Thunderbolts Project, I believe. And we did an interview and he said I wasn't the first scientist that had a download. There were, in fact, hundreds of them over the last decade getting instantaneous information from the ether, just like I did. And if you want to know about the Saturn myth and about what's actually happening, I'm going to leave you the PDF of the book for free. Now, Dave Talbot experienced a stroke due to space weather, unfortunately, and is recovering. But it is his work that has unveiled the lies that have been held before your very lives, the lies that the civilization we're currently living in is the last reprint of the last one. And we continue to get recycled due to these cosmic catastrophes, time immemorial. They occur at a time frame of less than 6,000, 7,000 years. The major catastrophes occur every 26,000 years during the precession of the equinoxes, and it continues. The mythology is clear. And I just interviewed Greg J over at his Greg J's channel on YouTube. And we're going to be continuing a discussion about Electric Universe, Velikovsky, the heresies, the deprecation of science, and the fact that the facts are before your very eyes, before your very lives. And our children are still being indoctrinated into a false cosmology that has nothing to do with reality. Now here a paper coming out April 1st, 1999. The distinction between geomagnetic excursions and reversals is pertinent in this discussion. Because it is my belief that 47 kiloyears ago, the plasma sheath was ripped from the polar configuration where Saturn was the best sun. And we are now living the nightmare that is skin cancer and the new sun for the last 47,000 years. And cosmic catastrophe after catastrophe has happened time and time again until the last reset 12,000 years ago, and we just began farming around 8,000 years ago. It's a game, kids. It's called reset time. In fact, the 7,000-year duration for geomagnetic excursion constrained by thorium-230 has been known as early as 2007. That's 12 years ago. That means these geomagnetic excursions can occur for millennia. And we know that there has major effects in the declination and the temperature ranges on Earth. These cyclic cosmic catastrophes are recorded by mainstream scientists, yet seldom heard about. High-resolution record of the Landchamp geomagnetic excursion at the Blake Bahama Outer Ridge. Now, this is the major 780,000-year polar flip, where north went to south and south went to north. But regularly, we experience excursions. And more importantly, my geologic work on the planet Earth has shown that we've experienced this type of catastrophe every 26,000 years for hundreds of millions of years. This means that the dynamo affecting us is either galactic or internal. And what I mean by that, it's either triggered by the Milky Way galaxy that we're in, or it's triggered by the actual planet that we live on. Which means there could be a plasmoid in the center of the Earth causing the Milankovitch cyclicity. If it's not that, then it's definitely the electricity at the core of the Milky Way. If you want to know more about this esoteric information and the fact that one day we were looking at Saturn in the northern sky, 24 hours a day, never moving, never setting, we were in the Garden of Eden. Constant warmth, constant pressure, constant temperature. And then one day, we got this. It's all coming to light in the mainstream. Reviews of geophysics, the role of geomagnetic field intensity in late quaternary evolution of humans and large mammals. The information is becoming clear. The Saturn myth is not a myth. It's science, and it's coming true before your very lives. We're not here to scare you. We're here to prepare you. Proper prior planning prevents piss poor performance. And the role of geomagnetic field intensity in late quaternary evolution of humans and large mammals proves that a geomagnetic excursion could not only last thousands of years, but it could also extinct your ass. Proper prior planning prevents piss poor performance. We love each and every one of you. It's good to see you. Subscribe to the channel. Share this with like-minded people. We are premiering an Electric Universe update with Greg J. tomorrow, where we're going to be discussing all of the Velikovsky heresies, including the fact that Einstein died with Velikovsky's book open on his nightstand. Nothing was done. No one is investigating this material. It's being banned from the internet. And as of today, YouTube has now blocked all fake science, according to them. It's getting real. It's 1984 exponential. Preparewiththeranch.com if you're preparing. Do it now. Do a dab. We love you. Be safe. Proper prior planning prevents piss poor performance in an electric universe. Deuces.